The NBA draft lottery was held a few weeks ago because it was pushed back due to the global pandemic. The draft lottery is to set the draft order for the 14 teams who missed the playoffs during the regular season. The order is determined exactly how they pick lottery numbers on TV. For anyone in New York, you'll know Yolanda Vega made this famous. Anyway, the order is set by a random drawing of ping pong balls, and the winning combination of numbers determines which teams will pick where in the draft. Of course, a worse record brings more likely odds to land in the top spot, but that's not guaranteed at all. Just ask the Knicks or Charlotte Hornets. And the reason why this is so highly anticipated is because all it takes is one young stud player that can truly be the difference between a lottery team and a team in the playoffs. So seeing which franchises gets an opportunity to be in that position is thrilling. Now, we are clearly a society that is enamored with conspiracy theories, so let's stroke that and ask if the NBA had a say in who won. What if they had an ulterior motive and wanted the stars to align perfectly for a particular franchise? Many people, including I, expected New York to win the 2019 NBA draft lottery and got ready to unveil the red carpet for Zion Williamson. It made sense, because the Knicks had the best odds, the largest market, and said market would have been able to maximize the star power of Zion Williamson. However, all Knicks fans, per usual, were disappointed. For me, it was as if the NBA jammed their fist in my chest and ripped out my still-beating heart. As we already know, New Orleans won the number one overall pick, but apparently this also made fans apt to cry foul and couldn't claim the league rigged the draft for the Knicks. But let's be clear, there have been some rather head-scratching occurrences surrounding certain draft lottery wins over the past 30 to 40 years, just enough to spark our inner conspiracy theory to full force. But before we jump in, please remember that if you've enjoyed the video thus far and can't wait to hear about the potential conspiracies that surrounded draft lotteries, please remember to hit the like and subscribe buttons, and make sure to tell your friends and family about the journey we are about to embark on. Now, let's dive in a bit deeper. The question of whether the NBA draft lottery is rigged has been around since 1985. Back then, the NBA Board of Governors had just instituted a lottery system for the draft, which, funny enough, is a response to claims that the old system, where the team with the worst record in each conference would decide who got the number one spot on a coin flip, was unfair. The irony. The grand prize in the 1985 draft was national champion and one of the greatest college basketball players of all time, Georgetown's Patrick Ewing. This was the draft of the bent and frozen envelope. And we all knew what the NBA was thinking. Wouldn't it be nice if this superstar went to a big market team like the Knicks to help boost the league's overall popularity? As luck would have it, the Knicks did win the lottery and selected Ewing first overall. And some people think the league helped set it up. In the first year of the draft, there were only 7 teams involved in the draft lottery. So, 7 team cards rolled around inside of a big globe, which then was rotated around a few times before the cards were drawn to establish what the draft order will be. When then NBA Commissioner David Stern selected the Knicks' envelope as having the number one top overall pick, there were some fans who observed that the corner of the card was a little bent. This signaled to the audience that this could have been a setup to help the Knicks get the number one overall pick. But to the non-conspiracy theorist, it also seems like the corner could have been bent from the ancient globe they used. That looks like something out of Zelda Breath of the Wild. But that hasn't stopped the loud voices of conspiracy theorists from accusing the league of gift-wrapping Ewing to the Knicks. Another insane conspiracy accusation was that the league froze the Knicks' draft card, as if it was a sausage, before the lottery, so that Stern would be able to identify the New York envelope by touch. Whether or not these accusations are true, Stern and the NBA brass was probably happy to see Ewing go to New York, where he helped revitalize the basketball scene. I, for one, am thankful for that. What I wouldn't do for modern-day frozen envelope. The next conspiracy surrounded the Cavs and LeBron. It should come as no surprise that there was controversy surrounding him before he even played one game in the league. The King was at the head of his class in 2003. If being one of the most hyped high school players ever wasn't thrilling enough, the young King actually had a chance to end up with his hometown team, the Cleveland Cavaliers, with that elusive first overall pick. The prior year, the Cavs and the Denver Nuggets ended the season with the league's worst record, giving both squads an equal shot to score the top pick. Well, we already know how this story unfolded. The Cavs got the number one pick and LeBron, the local Akron kid, got to play with Cleveland. But that seemed too much like a perfect fairy tale for some people. So, of course, people cried foul on it. But at the end of the day, it's not like Denver did badly. They did get Carmelo Anthony because Detroit, who ended up being the second pick, went with Darko Milicic. Remember him? Yeah, most people don't either. Next on the list is very similar to what LeBron's situation was, but this time it included the Chicago Bulls and Derrick Rose. The only difference is that the Bulls had a much less chance to land that coveted overall number one pick. The Bulls, who finished with the 9th worst record in the league, had less than a 2% chance of winning the lottery. Less than 2% chance. If that were the Knicks, they'd end up with the 14th pick. But somehow, someway, they defied all odds, and the Bulls did end up with the top selection and were able to bring Rose home to Chicago. As we all know, he was an MVP with the Bulls and was looked at as a god there, but he never won with them as he couldn't get over the LeBron hump and has since been traded a few times. Staying on the LeBron theme, there were conspiracies that not only his draft was a conspiracy, but other drafts were, quote-unquote, rigged to better help the king. When the Anthony Bennett experiment didn't work out, the Cavs went on to win the lottery again in 2014, which conveniently provided them with a valuable chip to lure LeBron back to Cleveland in free agency. As a reminder, Andrew Wiggins was selected by the Cavs, but only to be then traded to the Timberwolves in exchange for Kevin Love. But seriously, how many times did the Cleveland Cavs get handed the number one overall pick? Now, a conspiracy theorist may point out that the NBA purposely gifted the Cavs with this pick so that they could maximize their odds at bringing him back. If this was the case, it surely worked very well. The next is with the Pelicans, another lucky organization who lands the number one pick like it's going out of style. When new owner Tom Benson took over the team, they were in a bad place. They lost Chris Paul, previous owner had to sell, and they were ravaged by Katrina. So the new owner decided that they needed a clean slate. He decided to rebrand the team as the Pelicans instead of the Hornets. However, along with the new team name and uniforms, he also needed a new stud to build his franchise around. At the time, New Orleans only had the 4th best odds, a 13.7% chance of getting the overall top pick. Again, defying the odds, they got the first pick and drafted phenomenon Anthony Davis. And AD helped a franchise win a championship in the league. But it wasn't New Orleans. It had all the optics of being suspicious, as he was a new owner with a slim chance of getting the top spot, but who knows? Another similar example of this was the Orlando Magic, who won back-to-back draft lotteries in the early 90s after the team was sold. That stroke of luck got them Shaq. Can you think of any other NBA conspiracies? Let us know in the comments below.